Hey guys! It's been a while, but I'm coming back with a tutorial that I think could save you a lot of time and a lot of frustrations. I am using Clip Studio Paint right now, and I will be going over vector layers. Vector layers are something I just barely started using, but it saved me like so much time. It is so handy, and I think every one of you guys should know how to use vector layers. But before I get into the tutorial, I do want to mention that this video is sponsored by Amino. Amino is a free and easy to use app that focuses on communities. Any fandoms you're into, hobbies you have, there's a community for it, where you can interact with people with the same exact interests as you. You can share your passions through posts, polls, and images, but now there's a new way to share them. Introducing Amino Stories. Amino Stories are quick and short videos that, unlike the stories from other apps, will stay posted so that you can go back and rewatch them whenever you want. And if you find a creator you really like, you can actually follow them. There's even a bell button that you can click to get notifications for whenever they post something new. And guess what, guys? I even partnered with Amino myself so that I can make my own stories. If you look up my name in the search bar and click on the users tab, I should pop right up. The very first story that I posted actually has to do with the picture that I'm working on in this video, but we can talk about that later. I plan on making Amino stories for a lot of things, such as behind the scenes footage, video outtakes, and just a bunch of other things that I feel like don't really fit on my YouTube channel. So don't forget to download Amino and follow me there, and click the bell notification button. And without further ado, let's get back into the tutorial. Now, getting into the tutorial, we first have to learn how to make a vector layer. There's two different ways to do that. You can either scroll to the top left of the screen to the layer tab, go to new layer, and click vector layer. You can also do it a second way, which is the little button right next to new layer on your layer's sidebar. Right next to new raster layer should be new vector layer, and if you click on that, ta-da, one is made. And you can tell when a layer is a vector layer because it has this little icon next to it. So yeah. Vector layers are super handy for line art. You could probably use it for coloring, except that you can't use the paint bucket tool. See, if I click on the paint bucket tool and hover over the canvas, it won't allow me to do so. But really, it's really, really good for line art. There's not really too much of a reason to use it for coloring unless I just don't know enough. But this will be focusing on line art. And suddenly there's line art. I know this is a tutorial, but it is not a line art tutorial. It is a tutorial on how to use vector layers. It is 1 a.m. I don't know how to talk. I'm so sorry. So the first advantage I want to talk about that using vector layers gives you is when it comes to transforming your work. So those of you who work on Fire Alpaca or Medibang or Clip Studio Paint know that when you try to transform your line art or anything, the quality will be not so great. When you transform stuff, it will become blurry and it is very annoying. But that is only if you use a raster layer. When you're using a vector layer, it stays just as crisp. So I will be moving this messy line art to the side, and I will be copying and pasting it onto a new layer. And to show the difference, notice that the layer that I copied and pasted is also a vector layer. I am going to change that layer into a raster layer. So there we go. It is now a raster layer. So I'm going to do the raster layer first, just to show you what it will normally look like when you transform something. So let's do it pretty big. There we go. Notice how everything is very blurry. I know I used like a soft brush, so it's probably not as noticeable as when I use like a really sharp brush, but it is way blurrier than this. If I go up close, notice pretty sharp compared to not so sharp. Now let's go to the vector layer and do the exact same thing. I'm gonna try to get it as similar of a size. Actually, it's pretty similar. I'm gonna make it a tiny bit bigger. Might actually be bigger, but doesn't really matter if it's bigger or not because it's gonna be way sharper. Sorry if the audio is like, ugh. Let me zoom in to the vector layer and notice how nice and sharp everything still is. That nose compared to that nose, those eyes. Oh my gosh, look how bad that looks compared to Ta-da! I really hope you guys can see the difference. If the video quality isn't so great, you might not be able to tell. But this is such a great advantage. This by itself is, I feel like, a good enough reason to use vector layers. Crazy, incredible, amazing. Moving on. You may also be noticing how messy the line art is. There's a lot of intersecting lines, things that are they're just not where they belong. Well, fun fact. This is another reason why vector layers are great. There is an eraser tool that is separate and that can only be used for vector layers. So if you go to the eraser icon right here, the eraser tool, you will see right here on the subtool, there is a vector option. You cannot use this on raster layers. And I know that's pretty obvious. Right here, it's a vector eraser type. And there's three types. The middle one, in my opinion, is the most useful. The first one is called erase touching part. I'm not super sure how it works. If I try to use it right now, let me go up close so you guys can see better. If I try to use it right now, it's kind of weird. Like, I feel like it's supposed to be like a normal eraser. Like, it kind of works when you do that. But if you do like this, it like gets... Oh, actually, it's kind of working today. But earlier today, it just made it look really weird. I don't know. I guess it's just a regular eraser, but you may correct me if I'm wrong. The middle one is, like I said, the most convenient. It is called Erase to Intersection. And it pretty much just erases... whatever you draw the eraser tool through, so like draw a line through it, let go, and that intersecting line is gone. You may be wondering what really is the point of this tool. Like, you understand what it does, but you don't know what's, you know, why it's so great. I mean, it just cleans up line art, you know? Not everybody does line art this messy, and it's true. Not a lot of people need to use this. But for myself, at least, I find drawing line art to be way easier when I draw like overlapping lines. I'm able to get like whatever kind of curve I want more easily. And whenever I have to do that kind of stuff, I have to make a new layer usually. But now, when I use vector layers, I can use just one layer and not have to make 100. And it doesn't matter whether the lines cross because I know I can very easily erase it without like taking so much time, you know? Just look at that. I pretty much cleaned up everything. Let me do the eyebrows. Because you guys know I like to do my eyebrows over everything. There we go. I can clean that up a little later. I don't think it's gonna get this. Oh my god, it got it! What a great advertisement. Since I'm here, I'm gonna go over something super quick that I personally don't use too much. Just because I haven't really figured out how to use it well. But I'm going to go over the object tool. So it's going to be under the operation tool right on the side. It's going to be a little claw thing. And it's the object tool right there. And if you go over a line and click on that, you can change. You'll see a bunch of pinpoints like that. You can go ahead and change that. Like I said, I don't use this too often. But you could use it if, you know, you don't like the way a curve came out. So there's that you can use. I don't use it myself, but there's that. Da-da-da! The line art is pretty much done. There are some, obviously, smaller details that aren't in the line art, but those are the types of things that I like to do on different layers. So, the line art is pretty much finished. The tutorial is over. Just kidding! There's actually a few other things you can do using the vector layer that can be done after everything is finished. I'm going to direct you to the correct line tool. Is that what it's called? So on my tool thing right here, I hope, am I even recording this correctly? There is something down here that says correct line. Oh, there we go. And I am going to be showing you how to correct the line width or edit the line width. So I'm going to get rid of the sketch layer, go to the correct line width tool. And right here, you can see that I have many options, like thickening the line art and thinning the line art. And you can do this, you use this to edit the line art in certain, like, specific areas. So I'm going to use a thick width. There you go. You can edit how much thicker you want the line art to be wherever you go hover over, or not hover, but, you know, click on. So let's say I think this part is way too thin. All I got to do, go over that, Ta-da! Actually, I don't know if you're able to see that because it wasn't a giant difference, but if I go over the line art enough times, you will clearly see that it's just becoming super thick. That is obviously not what I want. If you're someone who wants to start experimenting with line width, but you can't really get it down right when you are actually drawing it, this is like a cool thing. What would your line art look like if like you started doing all the curves all thick like this or something? Now you'll know. And then if you don't like it, just freaking like undo it like that. Wow, what an amazing thing. Also, thin width, same thing, except it makes things thinner. So let's say I'm like, whoa, actually I do kind of think that this line is a bit too thick. Let me just go over it, maybe just like this part. Ooh, get this a little thinner. Ta-da! Actually, I don't like that too much. And the very last thing I want to talk about is changing the line art brush. This is something that I have not done yet, but I know it is a thing, and I'm excited. So, what if you draw something, you line art something, and then you're like, man, I wish I would have used this brush instead, or this would look way better if the brush was softer. You don't want to redraw the whole thing unless you want to, but like nobody wants to, so I'm going to assume you don't exist, but if you do, you are still valid. But if you are like most artists who don't want to redraw something, this is how you would do it. You can change the line art brush. So first you go to the object tool, which is this one, and then you change width of entire drawing by scrolling on the brush sidebar. I'm reading my notes. Oh, so I just realized that you can change the line art, like the entire line art, using the object tool, going down, scrolling down to the brush size option, and then just kind of scrolling through that. So that's also handy. But like, not as cool as the other one, you know? And now to get to the real point of what I was showing you, which is changing the line art brush. So right underneath brush shape, brush size, there is brush shape, which is a drop-down menu of brushes that are already pre-saved into, that were pre-saved into your program. Can I remember that word? So let's say I wanted to try this airbrush for whatever reason. Ta-da! Airbrush. Not looking so good. Let's undo that and let's try Bumpy? Oh. Does it look weird? I don't know. It doesn't look that weird to me. Let's try something else. Something like super obvious. Like Star? Heart? They all look the same. Oh. But yeah, pretty much that. I don't know. It looks pretty cool to me. I like it. Honestly, my program might be a little broken because it seems like a lot of these look the exact same. However, because that's wavy and it is not wavy. If your program isn't broken like mine, it should work awesomely. So there you go. Hey, what are all these like broken lines doing? I think those are intersections. I didn't do this. What the? Ta-da!
And before I end the video, I do want to say thank you to Amino Apps for sponsoring this video. You guys, please remember to download Amino and follow me there. I am going to post so many Amino stories. I have so many ideas. Hopefully you guys like them. I might like them more than you like them, but either way, it's more free content for you guys and content that you're not going to find on my channel. And without further ado, again, goodbye.